There are strong men and dictators around the world who think that I can do anything to stay in power. I can suppress journalists. But that's not who we're supposed to be.
On Thursday, the Treasury Department tried to exclude Fox News from pool coverage of interviews with one of its key officials. It backed down after strong protests from the press.
All the networks said, that's it, you've crossed the line.
Now the White House is arguing that the Fox News Network is not a real news organization at all. And that has brought some mainstream media voices to its defense. Here's ABC's Jake Tapper at a recent White House briefing.
He was putting it in a context and it sounded like that was evidence of them not being a news organization.
Why is the White House out to delegitimize Fox? Not because it has opinions, but because its opinion voices are so hostile to Mr. Obama.
Titled The Obama Administration in the Press, the report looks at the many ways President Obama has ushered in a paralyzing climate of fear for both reporters and their sources. Among the cases it details, six government employees plus two contractors, including Edward Snowden, have faced felony criminal prosecution since 2009 under the 1917 Espionage Act for leaking classified information to the press, compared with just three prosecutions in all previous U.S. administrations.
They've prosecuted more whistleblowers and targeted more journalists than any other administration, than all previous administrations combined. One of the things that I find chilling is the new program inside the intelligence community called the Insider Threat Program.
CBS News has obtained this video, a joint project of the CIA and FBI. It was made to warn intelligence officers.
I'm Special Agent McClain. This is Special Agent Kim. We're with WFO. We'd like to talk to each of you.
Of what to look for if the threat to national security is the person sitting in the next cubicle.
What just occurred to me, the number of times he would change his screen as I would walk into his office.
The president promised to have the most transparent government in American history. He promised to reduce overclassification. He promised to make it easier to obtain government information through the Freedom of Information Act. So far, none of these promises have been kept.
I can do anything to stay in power. I can kill people. I can throw them in jail. But that's not who we're supposed to be.
Today, we learned just how much authority the administration believes it has to kill, without trial or evidence, suspected terrorists. Even American citizens. A newly disclosed Justice Department document says American citizens tied to Al-Qaeda can be killed if, quote, an informed high-level official believes the target poses an imminent threat.
His citizenship should no more serve as a shield than a sniper shooting down on an innocent crowd should be protected from a SWAT team.
The Times reports that Attorney General Eric Holder, in a letter to congressional leaders, said the administration deliberately killed New Mexico-born radical Muslim cleric Anwar al-Awlaki in Yemen in September 2011. Three other Americans were accidentally killed in drone attacks.
I would have detained and prosecuted al-Awlaki if we captured him before he carried out a plot, but we couldn't. And as president, I would have been derelict in my duty had I not authorized the strike that took him out.